Assalamualaikum students, I hope that you are doing really well at your homes and you are keeping safe and you are enjoying your vacations and also giving equal time to your studies. In the previous lecture, we had discussed about the different type of systems in our body. We have different systems in our body. We discussed about the muscular system, the skeletal system, the circulatory system, the excretory system, digestive system, respiratory system, and we had also discussed about the similarities between the organs of humans and animals. So in this lecture today, we are going to start off with a new topic, which is keeping healthy. So what comes to your mind when I say the word healthy? So write it down or tell it to the person sitting next to you. So when do you think that a person is healthy? So when a person is fit, when a person is not ill or sick, when a person is here moving on its own, when a person is not lazy, when a person has no sickness or illness of any sort, then we can say that a person is healthy. But how can be a person healthy? What are the factors that keep a person healthy? So we are going to discuss that. You know, how, what kind of things or food that we need to keep ourselves healthy and energetic. So it is very necessary for all of us to take care of our bodies, because it helps us to stay healthy. Why is it necessary to take care of our bodies? Because it helps us to stay healthy. If you are going to stay healthy, then obviously then you are going to do your work on time, and then you would be able to eat properly, then you're going to be able to do your work properly, then you're going to be able to play properly, and you know, you can be a fit and healthy person. So okay, so what are the factors that we need to stay healthy? The first thing is that first of all, you have to eat healthy food. You know, whatever goes inside the body, it kind of shows on your outer side. So whatever you're putting inside of your body is very important. It is good. It is healthy food. It's not fatty food. It's not unhealthy food, because then you get a lot of different illnesses, sicknesses, and you know, you can't keep up with the pace of life. So you need to be healthy, and for that, first thing is you need to eat healthy food. So healthy food is the most important thing to keep our body healthy. The second thing is we should exercise regularly. Even it's not necessary that you have to go to a gym, or you have to go for a jog every day, or you know, you have to have special equipment for exercise. No, you can just make a brisk walk every day for 30 minutes is just healthier for you. So it's very important to keep yourself keep exercising every day so that you remain healthy. It should not always be a very strenuous or very difficult exercise. You know, you can just exercise like you can just do a little bit walk, and you know, whatever it is easier for you. Do not always sit around and do nothing and be a potato. Just exercise regularly. So first thing is eat healthy food, and second is exercise regularly. Third thing is taking care of our teeth, because it's very, you know, hygiene is a very important part of a person. So if there's an unhygienic person, if a person who smells bad, unhygienic food, then hygiene is very important. Like, you have to keep yourself clean. Not only keep yourself teeth clean, because when you're, because whatever, if you don't keep yourself clean, teeth clean, then you know, you're going to smell, and then you're going to, your teeth get rotten, and you're going to have tooth decay, and your mouth will smell bad, and And you know, when you have a poor mouth, when you have poor teeth, then you won't be able to chew food properly. So whatever goes inside your mouth, it goes through your teeth and your mouth. So it has to be clean, it has to be properly maintained. So for that, you know, you need to brush your teeth every day. Take care of your teeth. Do not eat unhealthy food. So these are the three main important things that are important to keep yourself healthy. And also you have to drink a lot of water. Water is very important. It helps you keep hydrated, and it gives you that, you know, you don't get lazy, and it's very important for your body to get a lot of water. So you at least drink 5-6 glasses of water every day. So keep yourself hydrated, eat healthy food, exercise regularly, and take care of your teeth. All these factors are very important in order to keep yourself healthy. Okay, so what includes healthy food? Now let's talk about healthy food. So this child over here is saying that I love my mother's cooking, it's so healthy and tastes so good too. I drink a lot of water in between meals because it's good for me. So you need to first of all, whatever the mother cooks for you, your mother cooks for you, and she knows the best. He will always take care of you, and he will always give you the right food. So whatever your mother says, listen to her and eat good food, eat healthy food. And it's so whatever your mother says you to not eat, do not eat that food, because it's not healthy for you. At the end of the day, if you are not healthy, and if you have some sort of disease, and you are laying on bed, you can't able to play, you will not be able to move around, and you will not be able to play games on phone, or you will not be able to meet your friends, and you will not be able to enjoy life. So for that, you have to listen to your mother, which is very, very important. Okay, so whatever your mother cooks for you, it's important for you to eat that. Okay, eat healthy food, eat what the mother cooks for you. So and I hope that your mother gives you good food, good healthy food. Okay, now we should eat balanced meals to make sure that our bodies are healthy. When you want to eat something, choose foods from these food groups: protein, carbohydrates, healthy fats, fiber, and vitamins. Be careful, eating too much sweets and other junk food is very bad for your health. So our food is divided into different categories depending on the kind of nutrition it provides. Our food is divided into different categories. So what are these categories? Proteins, carbohydrates, healthy fats, fibers, and vitamins. These are the categories that our food is divided into. You know, we divide different foods into different categories, just like classifying. This is classifying, just like you divide animals or human beings, or you classify different things on the basis of the similarities they have. Similarly, we have divided food into different categories. So whenever you eat a food, it will give provide you a certain type of nutrition. It has certain type of nutrition, and every nutrition that food has is important for your body. So some of the food that you eat, they give you proteins. Some of the food that you eat, they give you carbohydrates. Some of the food that you eat, they give you healthy fats. Some of the food, they give you fiber. Some foods, they give you vitamins. There are so many different vitamins. So you have to choose the correct amount of food. It's not necessary that you have to eat all the time. You have to eat proteins, or you have to eat, you know, eggs have proteins. When I say that proteins, which means if you want to go and tell your mother, mama, I want protein. Protein is very good for building muscles. So what you will do, you will go and you will tell mama, I want to eat an egg, because egg has proteins, a lot of proteins. So it's not whenever you feel like eating a carbohydrate, then rice has carbohydrate, and bread has carbohydrate, all these white flour, it has carbohydrate in it. Okay, so healthy fat, meat has healthy fat. So all these different foods, they have different nutrition that they give. it's very important for you to eat the right amount of nutrition. It's not necessary that you please you if protein is healthy, you eat all proteins all the time. And also, it's not if carbs are healthy for you, you eat carbs all the time. If you healthy fat is important, you just take it, eat foods that have fat in it or fiber in it or vitamins are important. You have to eat, you know, you have to make a mixture of all these things. Eating the right amount of nutrition, it gives you, and eating the right amount of food gives you good nutrition to your body. So these are different kind of food which provide different types of nutrition. So here you can see that this picture shows proteins. All these foods, they contain proteins. What do they contain? They contain proteins. Chicken contains protein, meat contains protein, yogurt contains protein, milk contains proteins, and cheese contains proteins, and yogurt contains proteins, and cornflakes contain proteins. Carbohydrates, bread has carbohydrate, pasta has carbohydrate, macaroni has carbohydrate, rice has carbohydrate, cakes have carbohydrates. There are different types of cereals, and these lentils, different type of lentils, they have a lot of carbohydrate. So healthy fats, what are healthy fats? There are some carbohydrates which have fats which are not very healthy. So if you are eating a lot of carbs, that is not good for your body. But there are some healthy fats like olive oil, olives, or some cheese, or some coconut oil, or all these different types of things. They have healthy fats in it which are good for your body. Then fiber and vitamins. All the fruits and vegetables, they have different type of fiber and different type of vitamins. Some vegetables, they provide you different types of vitamins, vitamin E, A, B, C, D, E. These are the name of the vitamins. So depending on the vegetable or the fruit you eat, it gives you vitamins and fiber, which is very, very good for your health. In order to keep yourself healthy, you have to eat a lot of vitamins and fiber. So include a lot of vitamins in your food. So next time if you eat food, you tell your mother that, mother, I want to eat a lot of fiber and vitamins. So and all these are, eat lots of these types of foods, because these are all carbs, these are all carbohydrates. These foods contain carbohydrates, and too much of carbohydrates is not good for your body. It does not keep yourself healthy. So cakes, these fizzy drinks, these chips, fried items, fast food, junk food, all this is not very, very healthy for your body. It's not healthy for your teeth as well. Sweets, too much sweets are not healthy for your teeth as well. So you have to eat less of these foods and more of these foods. Okay, more of foods that contain fiber and vitamins, and foods that contain proteins and healthy fats. So now I'm just finishing off here. So, but just let me know, what is your favorite food, and what do you like eating the most, and does it give you energy, and it helps you grow and keep yourself keep you safe from getting sick. So do you eat healthy? Ask your mother. Just discuss it with your mother. Mother, do I eat healthy? Or, you know, what's your favorite food? Do my food, is your favorite food a part of which category? Does it contain more fiber and vitamin, healthy and fats, carbohydrates and proteins? So discuss this with your mother, and watch this lecture, and I'm going to discuss in detail in the next lecture about proteins, carbohydrates, and all these other nutritions that we need. So till then, take care, and Allah Hafiz.